Hello friends, welcome to ProTalent and I am Nitin Parmar. I welcome you all for this module on current affair. Today, we are discussing about 5 I's group of nations. What do you mean by these 5 I's? They are the literal eyes on the world. Yes, indeed. So what happened? So when we talk about, we can say the World War I era, when we can say the various countries are fighting against each other, it was really a need of the hour to identify where the new emergent, you can say, fight is, you can say, getting up, and more importantly, identifying some, you can say, future problems, okay, and thereby they need to be in a continuous contact with each other. So at that point in time, it was all about radios, and through that, they were actually in contact with each other. The communication systems have started to grow. People and the countries have started to gain a lot of advantage of satellite, new technologies, and now through cellular phone, through, you can say, internet, and through satellite, they are able to look at the every country. And they are not just, you can say, looking at the problems coming from a country, but they are also looking and observing within the countries. So these are the 5 eyes. Now, why are we talking about this 5 eyes? They are the literal eyes of the world, okay, and these are the 5 countries that took this responsibility, and they said, we are in a network, we will share all our technology, all our information, all our understanding with each other. Okay, this is 5 eyes. Now, why it was in the news? Because recently you might have seen this kind of news. India joins 5 eyes group of nation, and thereby it became 7th member. But in reality, it is not. Still, 5 eyes are there. Remember that. Okay, 5 eyes are 5 countries. India and Japan. These are the 2 countries who joined this 5 eyes countries. Okay, primarily to sign against this end-to-end encryption by various, you can say, organizations like Facebook, WhatsApp, okay, they provide a communication between 2 people in end-to-end encryption mode. So that means when I am sending some information to you, okay, that information is traveling through the various medium of internet. Within that, nobody can decipher that. Okay, that is called end-to-end encryption. So when I'm sending something to you, you get it in between, nobody can take it. But governments need it. Yes or no? Why government needs it? Because when some wrong information is transmitted, it is really important for government to look at that information, to find out what are the challenges happening in it, what is the wrong information being spreaded, and thereby they can curb it, they can investigate. They can actually stop future, you can say, wrong scenarios. Okay, some terrorist activities are happening and that has to be controlled. How can they do that? So thereby, this 5 eyes plus 2 countries, that is India and Japan, have signed this, you can say, a petition or a kind of, you can say, covenant, wherein they are saying that we are against this end-to-end encryption. Okay, they said there is no access to content. They are not okay. Okay, we are not okay. They are against those companies which are providing such kind of end-to-end encryption. It says that it severely undermines the ability of company to take action against illegal activities on their platform, and through which you can say many wrong things are happening, like child sexual abuse, okay, terrorist content, human trafficking. Okay, lot of things are happening, and these countries are not able to take action against such kind of legal aspects. Yes or no? Great. So, what are the 5 eyes nations? This is Australia, Canada, New Zealand, UK, US. Initially, they started saying that we are intelligence alliance. ठीक है, वेर इन वी आर शेयरिंग इंफॉर्मेशन विच इज प्राइमरली रिलेटेड टू टेररिज्म. बट मिस्टर एडवर्ड स्नोडन ऑफ अमेरिका, ही वॉज अ मेंबर ऑफ NSA विच इज नेशनल सिक्योरिटी एजेंसी, उसके वो मेंबर थे. उन्होंने जिस तरीके से विसल ब्लो किया दैट इन द नेम ऑफ NSA गवर्नमेंट ऑफ अमेरिका इज टैपिंग द फोन ऑफ पीपल, इट इज ट्राइंग टू गेट कंप्लीट इंफॉर्मेशन ऑफ देयर सिटीजंस अगेंस्ट द प्राइवेसी राइट्स, दिस इज बिग चैलेंज. एंड फ्रॉम देयर द इश्यू केम टू द फोरफ्रंट दैट एडवर्ड स्नोडन वॉज यू कैन से एब्सकॉन्डिंग. And you can say the idea that these countries are using such kind of surveillance mechanism to control on their citizen is a big issue. Dosto, in any scenario, such kind of intelligence alliance is very crucial, so that in the world, when some wrong thing in a big way it is trying to get developed, it can be stopped at quite early age, at early stage, in an ascent stage. India was lacking such kind of intelligence, and thereby we got this parliament attack. Okay, so my dear students, it is very important for us to understand that such kind of intelligence gathering is very crucial. These countries are parties to multilateral UK-USA agreement, which is a treaty for cooperation in which signals intelligence sharing. Okay, so how did it all start? It started by Atlantic Charter, okay, which was issued in August 1941 to lay out the goals for allied group of power for post-World War. So, World War II, jab khatam hui, so they started saying that we would like to come together, try to see how we can try and share this intelligence to the all our member nations, so that in future we are not having any kind of trouble. So India is among those seven countries to back this UK-led campaign against this end-to-end encryption of messages by social media giants like Facebook. So nowadays, Facebook is also in a highlight. I'm sure you must be looking at the full-page advertisements happening by Facebook in the newspaper. Why? Because there are a lot of antitrust movements are happening on the Facebook. We will talk about this antitrust modules of Facebook in a separate video, but here we are talking about this is end-to-end encryption ke bare mein. Remember, still there are five eyes only, there are no seven members, okay, but India and Japan joined with this five eyes for this issue. Okay, remember that, this is very crucial. So what are the functions of this Five Eyes group of countries? They will exchange their views, they compare best practices and explore new ideas on the subjects. They explore areas where cooperation on reviews and sharing results is permitted wherever there is appropriate mechanisms are available. So these countries are more of democratic in nature. Okay, so they talk about that democracy is very crucial. Rights of people have to be protected. So to protect individual rights and to protect security of nation, safety of the people, so how to balance that is what this Five Eyes group of companies focusing on. That they encourage transparency to the largest extent possible to enhance public trust. More importantly, when we talk about all these seven nations are against this end-to-end encryption. So we talked about that end-to-end encryption means it is a private secured transmission of information. Okay, so for example, from my WhatsApp, I'm sending some message to you. It is end-to-end encrypted. Okay, so it cannot be read by anyone within the internet medium. Okay, so if someone would like to capture my information which I sent it to you in between, they cannot, because it is encrypted. It cannot be decodified by anyone except the person who is going to receive it. Okay, so if a person is going to receive that information, if only that person can decode it, the rest of the people, like government or any security agency, cannot take that data. Okay, so we need that data to maintain security and safety of the nation, and that's why the countries have, you can say, come together to fight against this end-to-end encryption. I hope this Five Eyes group, end-to-end encryption, and whether India is a member of this part or not is very clear to you. Yes, great, dosto. Thank you very much for watching this, and if you like such kind of videos, tell to a large number of people to be part of ProTalent. Is video ko like kariye, share kariye, hamari channel ko subscribe kariye, and get this PDF on protalentdigital.com. It is available to you free of cost. Okay, thank you, have a great day.